we looked at the first mention of Asherah, which shows it. Is the object of Yahweh's jealousy, and I think it's the first place he actually speaks of his jealousy, or he is named as jealous. But ye shall destroy their altars, break their images, cut down their groves. Here in Exodus 34:13, it goes on to say in 14, for thou shalt worship no other Elohim, for Yahweh, whose name is jealous, is a jealous Elohim. So it was the particular object of his hatred and his jealousy. He goes on to talk about making other gods in reference to it. It's part of the actual commandment not to have any other gods before you. Let's see. It was given to us to explain his name is jealous. He threats about it, about denouncing these things in 1 Kings 14:15, 15:1, 16:32 and 33, and 2 Chronicles 36:14. It led to Israel's banishment, Asherah did, from the land, and subsequently to that of Judah's worship of Asherah. This is how important it is not to worship these groves, these ancient groves, or trees in general. Even today, these tree huggers and people that worship trees, I love trees, but it's come to be a love-hate relationship. Where my house was in Canada that I just left, we had a 2,000-year-old tree in the yard. And there was something kind of freaky scary about it. I mean, it was a tree, but like I've seen with giant trees, they're very much living, and you sense that when they're extremely huge. And even though they're just a tree, there's something kind of monstrous about them, and they actually seem to have a soul, their own nefesh, their own soul. I can't say that for sure right now, I have to look into that, but it seems pretty clear from Ezekiel 31 that this is not just a tree, this is Satan himself, the soul, if we'll go that far, of Satan, was embedded in that tree that was cut down by the sword of Yahweh. It led to Israel's banishment from land. It's still preserved in valid language and secret fraternities like Freemasonry and the Masons, Theosophy, and in the Roman Church. Language so conceals it that probably those who use it today have little idea of what they are perpetuating. While the ancient symbols in Greek of I and O proclaim sex as the true god of hosts, as in the Kabbalah, as the Kabbalah declares. The Kabbalah is so messed up. Is the abomination of Antichrist, that Antichrist shall stand once again in the temple of Jerusalem. It is the abomination of desolation, symbolically saying, because that is also, we are the temple of Yahweh, so when we allow that abomination, when we allow Antichrist to live in us, we are setting him up as God in our temple. So that is also Matthew 24:15, where we get that last times so important revelation of what the abomination of desolation is. Here we are. The word Esher is noted in all the passages, and we've already gone to the first one. We'll go to the second one, Deuteronomy 7:5 in the Bible. And we'll look at each one of these. Deuteronomy 7:5 reads, "But thus shall ye deal with them. Ye shall destroy their altars, and break down their images, and cut down their groves, and burn their graven images with fire. For thou art an holy people unto Yahweh, thy Elohim. And Yahweh, the Elohim, hath chosen thee to be a special," which is peculiar in Hebrew, "people unto himself above all the people that are upon the face of the earth." That touches upon flat earth. How many faces are on the earth? One face. We're upon it. We're on the face of the earth. It says here in Deuteronomy 7:6. "For thou art," Yahweh did not set his love upon you, nor choose you, because you were more in number than any people, for ye were the fewest of all the people. So, when people talk about everyone coming from Adam and Eve, which is a whole different study, everyone being from Seth, people say anti-Semitic. Well, that would be everybody that came from Seth, which are all the 12 tribes, not just the so-called Jews. But there were the six-day people created on the sixth day, which were not in the Garden of Eden, and where they are today. What is a large study. They are different people in different nations. And they may even be beyond the ice wall. Many of these people, like Japheth, where did all the descendants of Japheth go to? They went into the north. So that might touch upon some